The Salt Lake City Mosquito Abatement District has proposed using an Air Force tanker plane to spray aerial pesticides this summer. Today, some concerned residents voiced their opposition to the plan. The proposal would involve using an Air Force C-130 tanker to attack airborne adult mosquitoes over 43,000 acres of wetlands northwest of Salt Lake City International Airport from August 30th to September 3rd. Dr. Ari Faraji says the aerial dispersal is safe and it's necessary to control mosquitoes and the diseases they carry.
Spraying for adult mosquitoes using ultra-low volume technology, or ULV technology, utilizes very small amounts of an insecticide over a large area. For example, when it comes to our Dibrome applications, we generally put out about 0.75 ounces per acre of that product. This literally translates to less than an ounce of a liquid solution that's aerosolized over an area the size of a football field.
Today at the Abatement District's monthly meeting, the Board of Trustees heard concerns from several environmentalists, bird lovers, and beekeepers.
The indiscriminate spraying using these large airplanes will undoubtedly impact the bee population.
I think it's really inappropriate to use C-130s to aerial spray a sensitive wetland like this.
Dr. Brian Minch of Utah Physicians for a Healthy Environment says the pesticides are neurotoxins which will attach to particles suspended in our polluted air and eventually wind up in the lungs of residents throughout the Salt Lake Valley.
It is inaccurate for anyone, including the Mosquito Abatement District, to say that this won't have an impact on human health. We have all these studies that show that these chemicals are really potent neurotoxins and have many other health consequences, such as precipitating things like infertility, reproductive problems, and even cancer.
Dr. Minch says the district's environmental assessment is full of errors, inconsistencies, and faulty science about the chemical.
It is harmful to children. It's harmful to the brain development of just about everyone throughout the age spectrum. It's even associated with increased incidence of things like Parkinson's disease and Alzheimer's.
The Mosquito Abatement District will accept written comments through the end of this month. We will put the link to their website on abc4.com.